the UV visible spectrophotometer. So in our department, biomedical engineering, SGSIT is involved. We have this instrument. Its company is Live India. Model number is UV3092, and it is a dual beam spectrophotometer. Basic function of this, it is based on the Beer-Lambert's law. I think most of you know what is Beer-Lambert's law. And if you don't know, then I will suggest that you please read it. According to this, you can find the absorption depending upon the concentration as well as the size of the sample. Okay. This instrument, as you can see from inside, you can come here. Here we have got a dual reference sample. In this, one is dedicated to the reference and one is dedicated to your sample, whose your absorption coefficient, or you can say, if suppose you have to determine the particle size, that you can calculate. Also you can find out the concentration of the sample. Okay, so we can calculate this with reference of these two. Now what happens for that analyzing, we use this cuvette. As you can see, the sample size of in this cuvette, it is 10 ml, and the dimension is 10 × 1 × 1, means 10 centimeter across 1 centimeter across 1 centimeter. In this, 10 ml of your sample can be held. Now what we do, in one of the cuvette, we put our reference. Suppose your sample or your material, whose absorption coefficient, a concentration, a particle size you have to find out, you have to disperse that sample in a liquid medium. Suppose we have water as a universal solvent, okay, and your material is suppose NaCl. You have to find out the concentration of salt in the water. So what we take pure water in one cuvette, and you can see, and we place this cuvette like this translucent side. As you can see, we always hold the cuvette using this translucent side. Other side means parallel side, it is the plain, okay, transparent side. So what happens, light enters from this transparent side and exits from this transparent side with the no interference from these sides. To avoid the interference, we always hold the sample from the translucent side, and also in order to remove any fingerprint. Because what happens, if suppose there is fingerprint in this transparent side, then it will hinder to the wavelength of the material. Wavelength of the light means, suppose in this case we use deuterium lamp, the range of that lamp is 190 to 1100 nanometers. So what happens, if suppose your any finger frame, or you can say your fingerprint, is hindering the radiation of the light, then it can change the course, means the light will be reflected or reflected from its original path, so you will not have the proper result. So that we always keep these transparent sides always clean, okay, means you can wipe this using tissue paper or any solvent, any cleansing medium, means dilute alcohol or acetone. You can clean the side, and now we place the cuvette like this. The transparent side, you have to place it very carefully, because this cuvette, it is made up of parts and it is very costly, you can say. Just a minute, I think there is some. Yeah. Huh. Now we have placed the cuvette here. You have to use two cuvettes at a time. One for the reference, one for your sample. You can change the position, there is no slot is dedicated. Now as we come to this side, here you can see these are the light source from the light is entering. If we open this chamber, you can find out that we have got two lamps here, a deuterium lamp and a simple, your normal hydrogen lamp, a normal lamp. So what happens, due to the combination of these two lamps, we have the radiation from 190 to 1100, means from UV to near infrared radiation, that much light energy or that much light radiation we can enter the sample. Now what happens, there is a beam splitter inside. That beam splitter divides that radiation into two equal halves, and from these two ports, from these two channels, the light enters in a parallel way. So what happens, one is the reference, and suppose you have taken the sample, what we are discussing was NaCl dissolved in water. So what happens, both the beams interact with our material, interact with solution, and then the transmitted light comes to this side. This side, you have got detectors, okay, radiation detectors. They calculate the amount of light absorbed. Means, suppose what happens, the intensity of light which is coming from the source and the intensity of light which is coming after the source, means while crossing the source, there is a difference. That difference is directly proportional to the absorption, sample length, as well as the concentration. So accordingly, what happens in this side, the detector detects the intensity of that radiation, and according to that, by detecting that intensity with your reference, suppose in this cuvette you have taken the reference and this cuvette you have the sample. So internally, what the circuit does, subtracts the intensity of the reference from the sample. So what happens, whatever the remaining intensity, means difference between the intensity we are having, that is because of a sample. Now, using different calculations, you can find out the absorption coefficient, you can find out the radiation absorbed, you can find out the particle size, you can find out even the electronic band gap also. Okay, that electronic band gap will be dedicated or will be specific to the amount or the radiation absorbed. Means, suppose there is a material that is absorbing a light in the range of 380 nanometer. So, according to the formula of EV equal to 1240 upon lambda, there is a formula to calculate the energy band gap. So, what you can do, using that formula, you can find out the energy band gap, or you can say the electronic band gap of that particular material. So, accordingly, depending upon your application, depending upon your need, you can use this sample in versatile fields. In the electronic field also, in chemical analysis also, in detection of some material also. Also, you can identify the nature of the sample. Means, is it a nano material, it is a semiconductor material, is it a conducting material. So, that all means multiple applications you can calculate with this instrument.